All right. Well, welcome, everybody. We're so glad that you're here. This is a great day, and we are so excited to cut the ribbon and get these buses behind us on the streets permanently here in the City of Falls Church. Yay! My name is Peter Noonan, and I'm the Superintendent of Schools here in the City of Falls Church, and couldn't be more proud to kick off the ceremony this morning. Obviously, we have beautiful, sunny weather, and I hope you're nice and warm for our morning. But what we do know is we are excited this morning, and electric school buses are going to impact our environment and the health of everyone in this community in a very positive way. We've got quite a representation of people here, including a portion of the community that involves and includes students, teachers, neighbors, parents, staff, community members, school administrators, general government staff, and elected officials. Students and teachers from the Meridian High School Sustainability Academy are here, and FCCPS is committed to sustainability in our curriculum, in our buildings, and now in our buses. The LEED Gold Net Zero Ready High School that we built includes geothermal heating, solar panels are on the way, electric car chargers are in, and now we have the electric buses. We have our Oak Street Elementary students here, and our teachers, so welcome. We are so glad you're here. I hope as you look at this these amazing electric buses behind us that you are inspired to think about all the ways that electric vehicles will make our years of bus riding not only more sustainable but also safer. And electric police cars are here as well. So thanks to the Falls Church Police who are helping out at this event as well. We have some people that came from far and wide as well. We have guests from Mothers Out Front are here, and Moms Clean Air Force. Yes, thank you to them. And they were key to last June's visit from Vice President Kamala Harris and EPA Administrator Michael Regan. So thank you so much for that. And when that happened last spring, and plans were announced for increasing the number of electric school buses here in not just the country, but also in the City of Falls Church, and we are so excited to take the next step today. I want to take just a second to thank our transportation department for their leadership and vision and the work that they've done to make what is happening today happen. And first and foremost, I want to thank Kristen Michael. Kristen, where are you? Woo-hoo. Kristen's back in the back. Kristen, thank you so much. Kristen's our chief operating officer and does everything in the system to make things like today happen. So thank you for that. I'd like to thank our transportation director, Regina Anderson. Regina, right here. Thank you, Regina. Regina and Kristen are the brains behind the organization here and really made this happen. Former transportation director, Michelle A. Johnson, who's now in Alexandria City, started the process. And when Regina started, she took over from there. And our school bus drivers are willing, able, and excited to learn the new systems and are ready to get these buses on the road. So thank you all for being here. At this point in time, I'm going to turn it over to Tate Gould, our vice chair of the school board. Tate, good morning.
Thanks, Dr. Noonan. Now, these buses are incredible. I think we're all excited to finally put our eyes on them. And I'm speaking on behalf of the board and Laura Downs, our chair, who is unfortunately not able to be here today. But I do want to welcome some folks that are here. I think we've got Jeremy Allen from Congressman Byer's office and Marcus Simon, obviously from always a representative of these type of events. We appreciate both of them being here. I've got school board colleagues here, Kathleen Tice, Lori Silverman, Jared Anderson, David Ortiz, and Sue Dimmick. Thanks for coming. Our city council partners, Debbie Hiscott, Mayor David Tarter and David Snyder are here, and Mary Beth Connolly is, there she is. And then we have a number of other folks that are here, obviously our students, our staff, and we're really excited for everyone to be here today. And I think in terms of these buses, I think we're all excited for this event. Personally, I'm very excited. I've got a CDL, but Dr. Nunes told me that I must focus on navigating school board policy and not navigating the buses around Falls Church City. But we are looking forward to one of our strategic focus areas is resource management and continuous improvement. And I think today we can really honestly say that we put a large checkbox next to the fact that we are focused on helping our environment with these electric school buses, our Leeds Gold High School, our Sustainability Academy, and all the efforts that our students and our teachers have been doing to help our environment. This is an amazing day for Falls Church City, and I think we're all excited to be here. I know it's hard to understand how much savings and how much impact we're having, but to try to give you an idea, 1 ton of greenhouse gases is equivalent to basically one person going from DCA to London and back. And in terms of these buses, this saves 13.4 tons of greenhouse gases annually. So I think with these two buses and all the other efforts we're doing, we're really excited to help out with the environmental efforts. So up next is Kaylee Edgerly, President and CEO of Sonny, Merriman. Kaylee.
Thank you, Dr. Gould. So as I see the pages turning in front of me with the wind blowing, I see the sustainability class here. The first thing I expect you to ask is, when are we going to put windmills on top of these buses? Right? I can tell you, the math just doesn't work out that way, but it's a very good question. I'm going to try to keep whoever's page it is here and just let that go. First of all, I got a few thank yous, too. First of all, thank you for my colleagues from Sonny Merriman that worked with the Falls Church officials coming here and setting this up today. We at the dealership are really proud of this bus and put a lot of time and effort into it behind the scenes. And I assure you, we will continue to do that 15 to 20 years down the road supporting these buses in your next electric vehicle purchases. I can only imagine Sonny and Lou Merriman 56 years ago when they started the bus could not imagine us here today celebrating the deployment of these two beautiful vehicles. So thank you to my friends and coworkers at Sonny Merriman. Also, thanks has to go out to our partners at Dominion, who you're gonna hear speak. But Dominion, they are a partner. They're a partner to you as a district. They're not selling their utilities. They're selling this bus going round and round. And we're in constant communication with them on our fleet across the state, which started with the first 50. And now this is part of the DEQ program from the state of Virginia. And DEQ deserves a little recognition here today, too, for making these funds available from Volkswagen. But Dominion cares first about transporting you on the buses. We also often get into conversations about them, about charging and vehicle to grid, which you can hear speak more about, but their first and primary focus is having these electric buses on the road and running. And for a corporation, I think that's very admirable. So Dominion, thank you for that. And then the last thank you goes to maybe the folks at Falls Church that first started this. And Dr. Noonan spoke of it. Within the transportation department, Michele raised her hand maybe one day and said, let's give this thing a shot. And then Regina maybe picked up on it and said, I'm going to continue with this. This can really be a cool thing. It takes that little change agent to make change like this happen, because it is a big change. And it often is met with some resistance within communities too. So I applaud the folks at Falls Church for having the courage, and then the board that supported them and kept everything rolling to come to this day. There's far more that you cannot believe goes on behind the scenes to make this day happen. So we're pretty happy and thankful. I'm proud. That's my next message. I'm proud to be standing in front of you today as a member and a resident of the state of Virginia who has the second most electric school buses running, only behind California. I'm an engineer. I haven't had time to do the math, but I bet per capita we lead the way. So I'm proud that you're taking part of that. Thank you very much. We at Sonny Merriman have deployed almost 100 vehicles, 100 of these. This is number 86 and 87. We'll hit the 100 mark next month with a few more deliveries. So congratulations on being part of the first 100. We've now accumulated close to 1 million miles on those 87 vehicles that are now on the road. We'll pass a million. We'll be at 2.5 million by this point next year, because we've got commitments for 225 to be on the road at this point next year. So the Virginia state, the Commonwealth, is doing a very good job deploying these vehicles. And then back to proud of Falls Church, you should be proud. You're the first you're the first 1% of something special, right? You're bus number 8687 out of 15,000 running in the state of Virginia. Do the math, that's 0.66. So you got in on the first 1%. We talk often about early adopters and laggards. You're early adopters, so your community, your community members, you should be very proud of it. So I'll close my remarks by saying I'm also excited. So I'm thankful, I'm proud, and I'm excited. I think of all the technologies I had growing up. And the one I thought of last night was, to some of us, you remember changing the TV station for your grandparents?
Yes.
You had to get up and you had to click, and then you'd have to click back the other way. That technology doesn't exist anymore today. It's not seen. There was a sweet time in our lives where we could click and have the remote. Now we only have the remote, so if it's lost, we can't do anything unless we find it. But at least technology advances. There's some other buses in your fleet that don't have, that these don't have a tailpipe. That tailpipe that's on those other buses in your fleet, it's a lot cleaner than it was 20 years ago, but it's still dirty and it still has a tailpipe. It's going to, that tailpipe's going to go just away, just like the clicker on your grandparents' TV. The other thing I'm excited about is this, these two buses being a member of your community. Just like there's probably some special Falls Church restaurant that's a community member, there's a special member that you always see at the grocery store that you're proud of. These vehicles are something to be proud of too, and are going to be members of your community for years to come. The sustainability class, I'll leave you with this. I think Dr. Gould talked about the 13 million tons of greenhouse gases that will be eliminated, and I got the same number. So it's always good when you show up with the same number. The equivalence of that, we decided, one of my colleagues decided to put that into context of birthday balloons. Anybody want to guess how many birthday balloons it takes to get 13 million tons of greenhouse gases? Go ahead.
Wow, 503,000.
Where'd this guy come from? Because I'm not that accurate, but the number is 500,000. So that's 500,000. So congratulations. Congratulations, Falls Church. And I'll turn it all over to my partner from Dominion, Josh Eagle.
Thank you, Kaylee. Clearly you're doing something right at Oak Street. You've got kids that can get the number right and number balloons. Thank you, Dr. Noonan. Thank you, Dr. Gould. Dr. Gould says he has a CDL license. I can assure you, he can drive one of these buses. They are cool, for sure. So thank you so much for having us today. It's great to see the students from Oak Street and the Sustainability Academy. We're really happy to be here to celebrate the deployment of these two buses. And hopefully they're just the first of many buses for Falls Church City. Dominion Energy is excited to support the adoption of electric school buses, as they are one of the most sustainable innovations to arrive on the scene in years. They offer so many benefits to the school children, to the environment, to the grid, and to this community. For starters, the air inside this bus is actually going to be 5 times cleaner than that in a diesel school bus. Look. We can get kids excited for that. That's awesome. But that air is also cleaner around the bus, which is awesome for the communities we live in. From an economic perspective, Regina, you're going to be excited about this, but those electric buses cost less than half of what a diesel bus does to operate and maintain. This leaves more money to be reinvested back into schoolrooms. Then there's the environmental impact. Like I said, transportation is the leading cause of greenhouse gas emissions in the United States. And replacing just one diesel school bus with an electric bus is the equivalent of removing 5 cars from the road each year. And additionally, when they aren't being driven, electric school buses can be used by the electric grid as energy storage. I know Kaylee was joking here about windmills, but we've got a great big project with Dominion Energy Virginia right off the coast. We're building a bunch of windmills out in the Atlantic Ocean. And these buses can actually act as battery energy storage for that energy off of the grid. So that's really exciting. So at Dominion Energy, our vision is to become the most sustainable energy company in the country, building a clean and sustainable energy future for the communities we serve. And electric buses are a really important part of that overall picture. But we can't do it alone. And it takes willing partners at the local level, such as the leadership team here at Falls Church City Public Schools, and Kaylee Edgerly and our friends at Sonny Merriman, to make that happen. Dominion has been overwhelmed by the enthusiasm from the electric school buses from school districts all around Virginia and the kids right here in front of us. We are equally enthusiastic to see the buses roll out as they begin to safely transport students and deliver so many other benefits to the community here in the city of Falls Church. Thank you.
Good morning, everybody. I'm Regina Anderson. I'm the Falls Church City Public Schools Transportation Director. And while everyone else has been waiting for this day, the transportation team has been hard at work preparing for today. We've all been trained on these electric buses, and as a transportation department, we are proud to be able to introduce the use of new technology into our community. Our drivers are known for great care, for the great care they put into safely transporting our students to and from school and their activities. Now we can do it quietly with zero emissions. FCCPS was awarded $530,000 by the Virginia Department of Environmental Quality, DEQ, to help support the purchase of two new electric school buses. The funding comes from Virginia's $93.6 million allocation to the Volkswagen Environmental Mitigation Trust, which supports initiatives to reduce air pollution. We are grateful that Dominion Energy Electric School Bus Program is expanding the charging station infrastructure at no additional cost to our division. Replacing diesel school buses with new electric buses will benefit our students and their health by reducing their exposure to air pollution. These new buses will also save FCCPS thousands of dollars in fuel costs for diesel fuel and reduce our dependence on fossil fuels. The new buses operate entirely by electrical power, which is pretty cool, help store electricity and stabilize the power grid. Sorry, gotta keep turning these pages. Creating a quieter ride for our students. Electric school buses provide a number of benefits, including reduced emissions, cost savings, and enhanced grid reliability through the vehicle-to-grid technology. After we cut the ribbon, you'll have the opportunity to take a ride around the neighborhood and experience it for yourself. I must say that the buses are very quiet. That's something that's going to be really significant because now you won't have to complain that the driver is yelling at your children over that engine because it's very quiet. It's almost uncanny. And Dr. Gould, anytime you want to take a spin, let me know. I can make that happen for you. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Kareem Doherty, the proud principal of Oak Street, and I'm really excited that you're all visiting us today. In school, as you can tell, we educate students about caring for our planet, and now we can continue that on our school buses, where they will experience live and in person the benefits of electric buses. Today, we have a number of students participating. There are some third grade students who are in our STEAM class, along with their teacher, Tosin Auditoro. And we have some fifth grade students who have been studying about environmentalism and climate change on their PYP exhibition projects. And our final speaker today will be Henry Tiedelman, a fifth grade student who has researched the importance of electric vehicles. So Henry, share everything you've learned about electric vehicles so far.
Did you know that gas vehicles are one of the worst? Did you know that gas vehicles are one of the worst type of vehicles because they are horrible for the environment? The smell is horrible. I can't even explain how bad the smell is. The smell is like a trash truck. Electric vehicles are better than gas vehicles because they're better for the environment. Electricity is not as much money than gas. And electric vehicles have a better performance than gas vehicles. Electric vehicles are better for the environment. For instance, gas vehicles pollute the air and electric vehicles do not. Greenhouse gases are part of the pollution. These gases make the planet warmer. Greenhouse gases, molecules in the atmosphere absorb light, preventing some of it from escaping the Earth. On the other hand, electric cars have a better battery than gas cars. Charging stations are places where you charge your electric vehicle. But when you use up a battery, you can still recycle the material. Recycling is better because it's good to reduce. Switching to a gas vehicle will reduce the carbon emissions a person generates by at least 30%.
What a wonderful representation of our students at Oak Street, don't you think?
Yes.
And so now we have our superintendent, Dr. Noonan, who will lead us in our ribbon cutting.
All right, so thank you all again for being here. The people that are gonna be most impacted by our electric school buses are our students. So I'm gonna invite all of our students and Regina, our Director of Transportation, up to do the ribbon cutting. Those of you that are adults and are electeds will take pictures after, but today we're going to let the students and our Director of Transportation do the ribbon cutting. So if we can ask them to line up here, and then we'll take some pictures while you're doing it. All right, I'm going to count. Once we're in place, I'll count us down. Oh, sorry. We can't get.
How are you?
Got it. All right. Are we all in place almost?
We're going to be on the
there, you guys ready? All right, here we go. 3, 2, 1, cut! Woo! Right on. Congratulations, these buses are official and on the road.